Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In the previous video, I told you about the monotone convergence theorem. So you saw that this theorem gives you some sufficient condition for a sequence of measurable functions such that you can eventually exchange limit and integral. In this video, instead, I'm going to tell you about the dominated convergence theorem, but it's similar to the monotone convergence theorem in the sense that, again, that's a result that gives you a sufficient condition under which you can exchange limit and integral. So I'm going to give you a complete proof of the theorem. It turns out that the proof is in fact based on the monotone convergence theorem. And along the way, to prove the result, we are going to prove another important result called the Fatou's lemma. That's going to be the first step to prove the dominated convergence theorem. So here is the statement of the theorem. We assume, like for the monotone convergence theorem, that Xn is a sequence of measurable functions, but instead of assuming that those functions are positive and that the sequence itself is non-decreasing, so we don't need any of those assumptions here, we are going to assume instead that the sequence is dominated by an integrable function. So that means that there exists a measurable function y, which is also integrable, so that means that the integral of the absolute value of y d mu is finite. And this this assumption of domination just tells you that for all n, the absolute value of xn is going to be less or equal to this integrable function y. So you see that because we don't have any assumption about the monotonicity of the sequence, nothing guarantees that the sequence indeed is going to converge. And so we need to add that in the list of the assumption. We are going to assume that this sequence xn converges pointwise to a limit that we call x. So you see that we replace those assumptions of positive and monotone with this condition of domination, and we need a pointwise limit. Then if we have those new assumptions, then we have a conclusion that is in fact slightly stronger than the conclusion of the monotone convergence theorem. So first thing, we can say exactly like for the monotone convergence theorem that the limit x is measurable, and also that we can exchange limit and integral. So the limit of the integral of xn is equal to the integral of the limit. But we can say a little bit more, in fact. Better than saying that x is measurable, we can say that x is integrable. So again, meaning that not only it's measurable, but also the integral of the absolute value of x d mu is finite. And we can state some kind of slightly stronger type of convergence. So that's convergence, in fact, in the L1 space, the Lebesgue space. That says that the limit when n goes to infinity of the integral of the absolute value of xn minus x d mu is equal to zero. Now you see that under the statement of the theorem, I also state some lemma. So that's another popular result in measure theory. It's called Fatou's lemma. And that's the first step to prove the dominated convergence theorem. So this one states that if you have, again, a sequence of measurable functions, now you just assume that you have a sequence of positive functions, then you can say that the integral of the lim inf of xn is less or equal to the lim inf of the integral. So that's again a problem of inversion of limit and integral, but in this case, we look at the lim inf instead of the limit. Why is that? Well, because there is nothing that guarantees a convergence of the xn anyway, but you can still define the lim inf. And instead of an equation, we have an inequality. So let's prove this lemma. I restated the lemma here. And in fact, the proof is not very complicated. It's just a direct consequence of the monotone convergence theorem. And to see where to apply the theorem, what you just need to do is write the definition of the lim inf of xn, okay? So if you write, so let's prove this. If you write the definition of the lim inf, so the lim inf of a sequence in general, and here it's a sequence of function, that just by definition, the limit of the infimum of all the, let's say, xk in the tail of the sequence. So, in fact, this limit when n goes to infinity is exactly the same as that's by definition, the limit when n goes to infinity of the infimum of all the xk, but then we look at all k larger or equal to n. So that means that instead of looking at all the sequence, you look at all the terms after n, and you look at the minimum of all of them, so that's well defined, and then you take the limit of that. So you see that the limit of this new object is indeed well defined, because this infimum here is going to be viewed as a function of a sequence, a function of n, that's going to be something that is non-decreasing. So the idea of the proof is just to call that, let's say, the n. You see that doesn't depend on k, k is a dummy variable, but then we can call that the n, that depends on n. and then the goal is to apply the monotone convergence theorem, not to xn, but to zn. So, to be able to apply the monotone convergence theorem, we need to prove a few things. So, we need to check that zn is indeed those functions zn are indeed positive. Well, that's the case because we assume that xn is positive, so all the zn are positive. We need to also check the condition of monotonicity, and yes, that's true, because if you really look at the definition here, we look at an infimum over all k larger than n. So if you increase n, you look at some infimum over a smaller set, so this infimum can only increase as n increases. So from the definition of zn, we deduce that, well, zn is going to increase. And so, of course, because that's a sequence of, that's a non-decreasing sequence, then this must have a pointwise limit. And what is the limit of the zn? Well, by definition, okay, limit of zn is exactly equal to the lim inf of those xn, okay? So this is going to converge monotonically to the lim inf when n goes to infinity of xn, okay? And so so we have all the ingredients we need to apply the monotone convergence theorem. So we apply the theorem to zn, and indeed that's a sequence of positive measurable function. The sequence is non-decreasing and the limit is lim inf of xn. So now we need to use monotone convergence theorem that's going to tell us that the limit of the integral of zn is equal to the integral of the limit. And we need to inject this somewhere in between here to prove this inequality. So let me start just with the left-hand side and see how it goes. So we just look at the integral of the lim inf when n goes to infinity of xn d mu. So by definition, this lim inf is equal to the limit of the zn. So I'm just going to replace this by integral of the limit when n goes to infinity of zn d mu. Now you see that this is where we can use the monotone convergence theorem. Okay, integral of the limit is the limit of the integrals, so that's equal to the limit when n goes to infinity of the integral of zn d mu. And now you can just argue. So now we want to connect this with that, okay? And so, and we have eventually an inequality. So the idea is really to say that, well, because the limit here exists, I can just write also that the limit is the lim inf, okay? We don't really need to do that. I just do that to underline just some connection after with this lim inf here. Maybe before I go further, I'm going to insist on the fact that this equation here follows from the monotone convergence theorem. That's where we apply the theorem. And so we have this, so it turns out that again the limit if it exists is also equal to the lim inf. So I can say that this is equal to the lim inf of when n goes to infinity of the integral of zn d mu. And now you see that by definition, so Zn is exactly the infimum over a set of functions that includes the function xn. So that means that by definition, Zn is less than xn. So because Zn is less than xn, and by monotonicity of the integral, I can say that without looking at the lim inf, the integral of Zn d mu should be less than the integral of xn d mu. And it's still true looking, of course, at the lim inf on both sides, because it's true for all n, that's also true for the lim inf. So eventually you get that this is less or equal to the lim inf when n goes to infinity of the integral of xn d mu. So you see that this proves Fatou's lemma. And so now we are ready to prove the dominated convergence theorem. So I rewrote the statement of the theorem on the board. You see that the assumption is that's the assumption of domination. We assume that for all n, absolute value of xn is less than some integrable function. So y in L1 is the Lebesgue space of the function that are integrable, and we also assume that xn has a pointwise limit that we call x. So we want to prove all that. So this first thing is in fact very easy. X is by definition the limit of xn, so that means that the absolute value of x is also the same as the limit of the absolute value of xn, but there are all, for all n, absolute value of xn is less than y, so that's also true for the limit. So, from this condition, and the fact that x is the limit, we can easily deduce that the absolute value of x is less than y. That implies, of course, that x, again, is integrable, because, well, this means that the integral of the absolute value of x is going to be less than the integral of the absolute value of y, which itself is finite. So that part is easy, in fact. Now, to prove this part, proving this is the difficult part. Once we get this, it's easy to deduce the convergence here, which is the same as in the monotone convergence theorem. So to do this, the trick is just to apply Fatou's lemma. So to the new sequence of functions, so Zn equals 2y minus absolute value of x minus xn minus x. So that's the trick. It turns out that you can indeed use Fatou's lemma for this sequence. We just need to check the assumption. So first thing we need to check is that Zn is indeed measurable. Well, that's the case because x, y, xn are measurable. So Zn is just a difference of functions that are like some differences of functions that are measurable, so that's still measurable. We need to check also that it's positive. Well, that easily follows from the triangle inequality for the absolute value here. I mean, that's true for the norm, any norm in general, but here that says that this quantity here should be larger than 2y minus absolute value of x minus absolute value of y. But we know that y is larger than the absolute value of xn and also absolute value of x. So 2y minus absolute value of xn minus absolute value of x should be indeed positive. So the fact that it's positive is not complicated at all. And that's it. So because of that, we can use Fatou's lemma. So before I'm going to apply the lemma, you see, you remember that the lemma tells you something about lim inf of the integral and integral of the lim inf. So that would be good first to look at the value of the lim inf of Zn. So I'm going to look at this before we write the equation. So here you see that the lim inf of Zn is equal to, well, that's just the lim inf of this quantity, but we already know that xn converges to x. So this part is going to go to zero. So if you want to write that in a better, I mean, like more rigorously, you would have that the lim inf of this quantity is equal to 2i minus the lim sup of this quantity. Have in mind that the lim inf of minus a sequence is minus the lim sup of the sequence. But here, this goes to zero anyway. So that means that the lim inf is equal to 2y in this case. Maybe to save space, I can write it there. So I'm going to say also that the lim inf of Zn is equal to 2y. And that, again, directly follows from the fact that xn goes to x. So now we can apply Fatou's lemma. Remember, it tells you that the integral of the lim inf here is going to be less or equal than the lim inf of the integral. So you see, because the lim inf is 2y, I'm going to start with that. So first step is to write that integral of 2y d mu. So by this property that just equal to the integral of the lim inf of Zn d mu. Okay, now I'm going to use Fatou's lemma to say that this quantity is less than the lim inf of these integrals. So lim inf of the integral of Zn. Integral of Zn d mu. Okay, so here I'm insisting on the fact that this is this in for this inequality that we use Fatou's lemma. Okay, and then next step, well, we can just replace Zn by its value here, the definition. So we know that this is also equal to the lim inf of the integral of this quantity. So we have 2y minus absolute value of xn minus x d mu. Here we are again going to use the fact that lim inf of minus something, it's minus the lim sup. So this means that, so what I'm going to do here is two little things. It's first use the fact that the integral is linear to say that, well, this quantity here is just integral of 2y d mu minus integral of absolute value of xn minus x d mu. But then the lim inf of minus the integral is the same as lim inf of minus the integral is the same as minus the lim sup. Okay, so eventually we get that this is equal to the integral of 2y d mu minus the lim sup of the integral of absolute value of xn minus x d mu. Okay, and so clearly, I mean, those things are positive, okay? You have positive measure, positive function. You take the lim sup exists. This part here is clearly positive. So this whole expression should be less than integral of 2y d mu. So eventually, this is, you see, less than integral of 2y du. And we are done. What is that? Well, because look at what's going on. We started with integral of 2y du. We end up again with integral of 2y du. So in fact, all the inequalities along the way, so that's just this one in fact, is an equality, it's an equation, same for this one. And so eventually you conclude that this lim sup should be zero. Okay, that's the only possibility. This thing should be equal to that. And so that means that this part is zero. And then we are done with proving this. So I'm going to just rewrite quickly this statement. So what we have here is that the lim sup of the integral of absolute value of xn minus x du equals zero. So of course, the lim inf, those things are positive. So the lim inf cannot be negative. And so that means that the lim inf has to be positive, but it's less than the lim sup. So they are both equal to zero. So that means that the limit exists. And the limit is zero. So that's exactly this statement. So eventually we get this. And then to conclude, to get the last property, that's pretty easy. That follows again from the fact that the integral is monotone. So to get this one, I'm going to look at the difference between like those terms and the limit, and just prove that this goes to zero. So that's the integral of xn du minus the integral of x du. Now, this quantity, by the fact that the integral is linear, I can rewrite this as the absolute value of the integral of xn minus x du. And now I'm going to use the fact that the integral is again monotone. And then say that the integral of xn minus x should be less than the integral of absolute value of xn minus x. And so you can put absolute value inside. The quantity here becomes positive, so you don't need the absolute value outside. So eventually, you end up with saying that this is less than the integral of the absolute value of xn minus x du. But by this part of the theorem, we know that this goes to zero when n goes to infinity. So eventually you get that the difference between those two terms goes to zero, which is exactly the same as saying that the integral of xn du goes to integral of x du, and this concludes the proof of the dominated convergence theorem.